Hello friends, we'll continue with the principal stresses. Now in the diagram you can see here, I have a planar 2D figure on which we have sigma x acting and I have sigma y acting. Okay, so I have here sigma x, I have here sigma y, and there is some external shear stress acting as well, tau xy. So I have a biaxial system on which I have sigma x, sigma y and tau xy. Now I want to evaluate on this plane theta, on this plane theta which I have zoomed and shown here below. So this is my sigma x, this is the plane on which the sigma x is acting on this plane, and this is the plane on which I want to evaluate what is the normal stress sigma theta and what is the shear stress tau theta. So on this plane I want to evaluate normal and shear stresses. Alright. Now how to do that? So on any angular plane, if I want to evaluate sigma theta and tau theta, what is the formula for that? Well, if you see here, sigma theta is equal to sigma x plus sigma y by 2 plus sigma x minus sigma y by 2 cos times of cos 2 theta plus tau xy sine 2 theta. So knowing the stresses sigma x, sigma y and tau xy, and knowing the plane on which you want to evaluate normal stresses, we can evaluate a normal stress acting. Okay, this is another important formula that one needs to remember from gate perspective. So using this formula, I can analytically evaluate on any plane what is my normal stress, provided we know the angle of the plane and the external stresses which are acting on the plane, on the planes. Okay, so sigma theta can be evaluated by using this formula. I even need to evaluate what is tau theta. So tau theta is sigma x minus sigma y by 2 sin 2 theta minus of tau xy cos 2 theta. So if you see, it's very easy to remember this formula. The only catch in tau theta is I have replaced this cos 2 theta by sin 2 theta and this sin 2 theta by cos 2 theta and reduce a negative sign here. So if I want to know what is tau theta, I'll take this much portion of the formula and swap this sin theta and cos theta, and in place of positive sign I'll introduce a negative sign. Okay, so I have sigma x minus sigma y by 2 cos 2 theta minus tau xy sin 2 theta as a formula for tau theta. Alright. So using these two formulas, I can evaluate what is normal stress on any plane theta and what is shear stress on any plane theta, provided the external stresses are known and the angle on which you need to evaluate the stresses is provided to you. These two formulas are very important from gate point of view. Now in the previous session, we learned about what do you mean by principal stresses and what do you mean by principal planes. Now, while defining principal planes, I gave you two definitions. One definition says that they are nothing but planes on which you have maximum and minimum normal stresses acting. The other definition said those are those planes where shear stresses are zero. Okay, so I'm going to utilize this formula of shear stress to find out the location of principal planes. So according to the other definition of principal planes, which says planes, those are the planes where shear stresses are zero. So principal planes evaluate karne ke liye maine tau theta equal to zero kar diya under. Okay, so maine ye equation ko I've equated it to zero. So tau theta is zero and I'm substituting this condition in equation 2. Okay, so what do I get here is, after equating I'm rearranging it and I get this step. Okay, and now I have just taken cos 2 theta here, cross multiplied, and I've got this equation. Tan 2 theta is equal to 2 times of tau xy, sigma x minus sigma y. Now, this is an important equation. This equation actually gives you the location of principal planes. So, location of principal planes is evaluated by this equation. Tan 2 theta is 2 times of tau xy upon sigma x minus sigma y. Okay. Now, If you see this equation, I have written here point, using equation 3, we get theta 1. Okay. Now, in a 2D system, we are dealing here with the 2D system. In a 2D system, I am going to have two principal planes. In a 3D system, I am going to have three principal planes. Okay. So, one of the plane here in a 2D system will be that plane where the normal stress value is maximum, and the other will be the plane where the normal stress value will be minimum. So theta 1 corresponds to one of the plane, which can be evaluated by this particular formula. If I want to evaluate theta 2, theta 2 is simple. Whatever you get here plus 90 degrees. Whatever you get in by this equation plus 90 degrees, you are going to get theta 2. Okay. So what is the learning that you get from this equation is, there are two principal planes for a 2D system, there are three principal planes for a 3D system, and principal planes are separated by 90 degrees. This is the equation that tells you that. So principal planes are always 90 degrees apart. Okay, so we'll just quickly recap what we just learned today. So I have a planar figure here, a 2D system on which I have sigma x and sigma y, tau x y acting. I want to evaluate on any plane theta, what is the value of normal stress and what is the value of shear stress. To do so, these are the two equations that we are going to use. Okay, and I told you the procedure to remember this equation is, simply swap this sin theta and cos theta and introduce a negative sign in place of positive here. Okay, to evaluate principal planes, another definition of principal planes said that those are the planes where shear stresses are zero. So I've equated zero here and I have rearranged this formula, the RHS of it, and got this result. Tan 2 theta is 2 times of tau xy sigma x minus sigma y. This formula gives one of the plane of one of the principal planes. If you want to evaluate the other principal planes, what you need to do is add 90 degrees to it. So there are two learnings that you get from here, that for a 2D system you are going to get two principal planes, for a 3D system you are going to get three principal planes, and the principal planes are always 90 degrees apart. The principal planes are always 90 degrees apart. This is what you need to remember. Well, this is it from principal planes. We'll continue principal stresses in the next session as well.